Hi, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about shapes, about nail shapes, all the different ones. Well, there is like so many, it's unbelievable. I've selected four shapes to show you. Okay, so ballerina is really popular at the minute. Some people call it a coffin shape. I think that's really bad. I wouldn't call a shape coffin, it's a bit morbid, but I prefer the ballerina. It's like a ballerina slipper, so it's like a block. With this shape, you have a straight side wall. So it runs straight out of the natural nail and comes straight out, okay? You have a lovely soft apex, and then it tapers down. So this comes down. This is straight. So you can see from your diagram exactly what I mean. And this is the side view. This is your lovely little finger here. This is your side view. And you have a itsy bitsy teeny weeny C curve at the end. It's very similar to a stiletto nail that's been lobbed off at the end. So it's squared off. I always say that they look like stilettos that have been lobbed off at the end. They're great if you break a stiletto. Really good. If you break the end of your stiletto off. Oh, look at that, I have ballerina nails. So when you're looking at the overview, so the plan view of the nail, drawing your little diagram here. So it's nice and flat here. So these come in and this is nice and flat. It's gonna taper from the widest point down to quite a thin point. The longer this nail is, the more dramatic the shape's going to be. So I'm going to show you now what it'd look like on a shorter nail. So if the nail was about here, we'd probably take it to this shape. So you still have a thin side wall coming in, and then it's nice and flat at the front, but it's not quite as thin as if it was longer. The longer it is, the thinner the end will be. Okay, it just, that's how it works. It looks more pretty. If this is even shorter, we would come in here and then straight like that. You know what looks really cool on this shape? To do your smile line the same as the free edge. By that, I mean this. So I'll just color this in. I'm going to colour all of this in. I want you to sort of understand what I'm talking about, okay? So imagine this is, I don't know, whatever colour you want it to be, purple or whatever. So imagine that free edge is that colour. And then your smile line is the same shape as your free edge. So you have this straight, straight, and then straight at there. So this would be a nice soft, you know, pink, so you probably use natural beige or warm natural beige on this part here, and then a nice colour there. And it just exaggerates the shape and the style of this nail, which is super popular. That's the ballerina nail. I'm gonna move on to my next nail. And we have a competition square. A competition square nail is slightly more exaggerated than a salon square nail. So you have very straight side walls. This point and this point are the same depth. So all the way through here, it will be the same depth. Same as that there, same as that there, same as that there, until you get to the apex. And then it's going to softly slope down and go flush into the cuticle, nice and crisp and no ledge or anything like that. You've got a 50% C curve, which makes it super strong and super gorgeous. And then you have a really deep smile line. Fair enough, if you don't want a smile line, you want to do a full colour nail, that's fine. But this is just a competition style square nail. If you were doing salon square would be a lot shorter. Maybe about there. And your smile line would be a little bit softer. So it would appear like this. The side walls are parallel, where you look at the overview, so you're looking down on top of the nail, parallel, running straight out of the natural side walls of the natural nail. Everything's very straight and very perfect when you do a competition style nail. So that's your competition square. And now we're going to do stiletto. So a stiletto, some people do stilettos really flat. They look naff. They still need to have a C-curve that runs underneath the nail. Really hard for me to draw that because I can't show you underneath the nail. So underneath here will be a curve. This is not a flat nail. Flat nails will break, especially if they are stiletto. You still have a nice apex. Obviously, I've exaggerated this a little bit for you so you can understand what I'm talking about. It comes straight out of the side wall. It does not drop down. It does not go up. It's straight. It comes sloping up to your apex and then it goes down to a very fine point. When you have created this nail, or when you are creating this nail, you will pinch this nail. The form fit will be perfectly pinched, or the tip will be perfectly pinched. And you will have that nice C-curve. So nicely pinched, not flat. If it's flat, it will break and it will look naff. So a nice pinch to create a C-curve underneath the nail. So if you turned the nail over and looked at it, you would see, oh, it's that very nice curve under there, keeping it nice and strong. Okay, and then the point, the very pointy. Some people in a salon, doing a salon stiletto nail, would do, let me draw this for you, a nail that comes in like this. And instead of doing a really sharp point, we would just soften that point off, just to make that a little bit more wearable for our ladies. Clients do actually have jobs and do things, so they don't want to be stabbing people and piercing their own skin with the nails. So you would just soften that off a little bit. So don't forget, when you stiletto, you still want a nice pinch to create a C-curve underneath the nail. And don't forget, straight out from the side walls, a nice soft apex that drops down. Okay, that's the stiletto. An edge nail. I would say these were really popular last year and the year before. I definitely think the ballerina's taken over the edge nail. However, the edge nail is a beautiful nail. It's quite difficult to do, but it stretches your skills when you do it. So have a go, because it really kicks you up the butt and makes you work hard, okay? So when we're talking about the edge nail, it's going to come straight out of the sidewall. It's not going to drop. It's not going to go up or anything like that. Nice and straight, clean lines. And then you're going to have an apex. So it's gently coming up in the back third of the nail and then going straight. The distance between here and here and here and here, all the way to your apex, will be the same. So say this is 1 inch, this will be 1 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch. Obviously that'd be a big nail. It wouldn't be 1 inch, it'd be more like, I don't know, 5 mil or something. But it needs to be the same all the way through. An edge nail has a rooftop to it, so it has a point like this running down the nail. So you can see that in this little diagram here that I've done. So it's flat here, flat here, and that runs all the way down the nail and then softens off. It goes soft, 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 and it's just round. When you come to the apex, you're just going to soften that off and make it round. Also, when you're doing an edge nail, it looks better if you do a chevron smile line, so a nice pointy V. And the V smile line needs to be, really, to make it look nice, the same as the free edge. So this shape here will be the same as this shape here. Okay? So you've got straight parallel side walls when you look at the top view of it. So when you look at the nail like this over the top, you have got a straight parallel nail. The spine of the edge nail runs in the middle of the nail. So it's not going to be on one side or the other side or it's skewiff or anything like that. It's going to run directly down the centre. So you've got that spine that's really crisp running down the centre of the nail. When you look at the nail, down the barrel of the nail, like this, or like this too, it will look like this. So that's what your C curve will look like. It will then become an upside down V. So this is your spine, and this will be the bottom of your side walls. Does that make sense? I hope so. And that's the edge. I hope you understand that.